Yo, what is going on, my people? My people, what's happening? You are tuning in to the No Compromise Media here with Dave, aka Doffity, and my boy MJ. That's my brother. My brother, MJ. I'm not gonna say his last name, but just know him as Master. Master. So MJ, that's my boy, man. Yo, MJ, what's good, brother?
What's going on? AKA Malik John Artist.
Thank you for clearing that up. MJ stands for Malik John Artist, you know what I'm saying? But, you know, he is a master at what he do. Definitely a professional. Yo, so, you know, one thing I forgot to ask you, man, on the last podcast that we did.
Okay.
I wanted to ask, how long you been actually doing art?
How long have I been doing art as a whole?
As a whole, all together. How many years has it been?
Oh man, my whole life, bro. My whole entire life. Ever since I was a little child. And the funny story is, I remember this story that my mom told me. So, okay, she told me, I don't know if it's 100% fully accurate or if I got it completely right, but from what I remember, she said that when I was a little child, I was very hyper. And so, her solution to calming down, my hyperness, if that's a word.
Yeah.
She gave me a piece of paper and a crayon or a pencil, and I just started doodling. And from then on, it was just me doing art. She literally still has, I believe to this day, she still has this scribble scrabble painting I did where I just spread paint all over with my hands.
Right.
And as I was looking at it, like, what the hell is this? And I was as I got older, like, what the hell is this? She said, that was you. And I'm looking at it like, ugh. But she never wanted to throw it away. So, but ever since then, I've just been doing art ever since. So, watching Bob Ross.
Absolutely.
Bob Ross. Mm-hmm. Just seeing him just creating paintings of landscape just from like within 30 minutes. 30 minutes, bro. 30 minutes.
Yeah.
And my like just watching it with my mom and my sister, and we were just all just blown away, like myself specifically, and I just knew that this is what I want to do. Now, I didn't know that, now at that time, it was just something I like to do for fun. I didn't look at it as, okay, this is what I want to do as maybe, you know, as means to make a living. Mm. But I knew that was something that I enjoyed to do. It bring me joy. Now, for in terms of painting, I didn't learn how to paint until I was in college. Actually, matter of fact, my
wow,
first thing,
okay.
The first thing that actually I did was back when I was, I think I was 17, 16 or 17. Yeah, and it was a painting. It was like 8x10, and I used actual oil paint. It was a gift from, I think, my mom or my sister. And I had no idea what I was doing. All I knew, I was just using what colors that I thought would go with the typical simple things, you know, like logical stuff, like, you know, the sky is blue,
right.
Water is blue, both. I painted whatever color I wanted, sand, brownish. You know, I made a mess, but it was a painting, and then, me actually learning how to paint, like learning how to use the colors, choosing right colors, stuff of that nature. That's what I learned in college. Wow. Now, mind you, I didn't know how to paint to save my life around that time. My stuff didn't look nothing like how it does now. It just looked like something like maybe Basquiat would have done. And the crazy thing is that. That moment right there, it really humbled me. It discouraged me at first, but then again, it actually also humbled me because when I before I became to college, before I went to college, I came in there thinking that I was the shiznit.
Right.
I came up like with a cocky attitude, being like, nobody can mess with me. I'm the best artist there is. I literally felt that way, because when I was in school, I was literally mainly the only student that was known for doing art. There was some other art. I mean, there was some other students that did art too, but I was more well known. More, and people coming at me saying, "Oh, you're so great! You're so gifted! You're so talented!" Yada yada. No, people coming to you to ask you to maybe draw them something and everything. And that can go to your head and blow up your ego. So when I came to college and I'm seeing there's other students that are great as me or even much better. Like there was this student that I remember, he would literally just look at a model just for a few seconds or maybe like up to a minute or so, and he would just start putting the paint, whatever paint that he wanted on the palette. He wouldn't even do an outline. He would just start painting.
Yeah.
And I'm looking and I'm thinking, what the hell is he doing? Not to create an outline first? And every time, and he would, and mind you, he would finish for everybody. And I'm like, how the hell did he finish over there? I come to his to his paint and see it, and it looked so realistic. Like he was able to put the paints and mix it all together, and the painting looked exactly like the model that was there. And
wow,
I was mind blown. I'm thinking, how the hell did you do that? And he's just, hey. No, it's the sad part though was that he wasn't motivated though. He was a terrible student. Yet he had this incredible talent.
Right.
And just right. Seeing that, just I guess it made me it motivated me to really get up on my game and learn what I needed to do, even though it was hard at first. It was very frustrating. But eventually I got better as I got along. So
gotcha.
That's when I learned that consistency is key. Like, keep going at it. Eventually you will get it.
Got you. So, yo, we're going to do a show and tell right quick. Show and explain, I guess, right? And my brother is, he sent, and by the way, if you, and he'll give, I'll have his link. You can see his link right on here to purchase his paintings, to even just drop by his website or drop by his Instagram and just acknowledge and just say tell him how much you appreciate his art or what you think, his thought, your thoughts, positive thoughts on his art. Let me do a show and tell, and I'm gonna randomly select some, and I like for you to just explain this. We did it before, but I want you to expound on this one. Hold on, my fault. I have one that you sent. I thought it was phenomenal. Hopefully you can see this one, brother.
Oh, yes.
You can explain.
Yes, I love this thing.
If you can explain that one and who it is actually in there, just.
Okay. This one's going to take a while, because each person in that painting has a significant, what's the word, that holds a significant part of me in my journey.
Okay.
Okay, so I'm going to break it down. So basically, it's called the My Mount Rushmore of Art, because, of course, it's my version of Mount Rushmore. So basically, I wanted to pay homage to four artists who have made a major impact in my life as an artist. So I'm going to start with the guy so if you put it up. All right, I'm gonna start with the guy with the afro. Of course, that's Bob Ross. So, like I said before, that I watched him as a child, and creating landscapes out of basically from his imagination, and creating them within 30 minutes. And like I was saying, how it was just so blown away by it. And just seeing him doing that, it just made me, first of all, maybe want to draw myself landscapes. Cause I used to draw landscapes growing up from my imagination too. It wasn't, of course, I mean, it wasn't anything near as, you know, on his level, but you know, the fact I was doing it was a big thing. And you know, I used to get a lot of praise for it, and it motivated me to know, of course, that this is what I want to do. This is what brings me joy. So I would say, if I was to be asked who is like your top favorite artist of all time, period, it'd be him. Now for the guy after him, that guy is Rembrandt. Rembrandt is, I'm not sure if you're familiar with Rembrandt, but Rembrandt, he's a very well-known Renaissance painter back in the 1600s. He's someone that I studied back when I was in college. So he was, out of all the like the Renaissance master painters, he was someone that I gravitated to the most. I forgot the actual reason, but for some reason I just loved his work the most of everybody. So there was this assignment that I did back in college where the assignment was that you can choose any Renaissance master you want to redo one of the paintings. But the thing is that you had to take something from today's era. So I chose one of his self-portraits. And what I did was I redid a self-portrait I did of him, but I added, I included, those diamond medallions of the Jesus piece?
Yeah.
So I included that. So I have it here somewhere. I have it stashed away here somewhere, but yeah. So, all right, the guy in the far right, the bald-headed guy with the glasses, okay. I'm not sure, are you familiar with this guy named Kevin Walk Williams?
No, I'm not familiar with him.
Oh, man, you need to see his work. So, he's very well-known. He's very well-known. I'm pretty sure you've seen some of his work. Just, like, probably not, haven't recognized it, okay. He's known for making black love art. And his work can be found in Pinterest or Google, things of that nature. You probably have seen this stuff. You just don't recognize it anyways. Before I was doing Black Love theme art, I was just, you know, just drawing whatever looked appealing to me. Like, there was, like, no direction. I just draw whatever. If I saw a picture of a dog, I draw that. If I saw a picture of some things, I would draw it. If I saw a picture of a person, I draw it. So I didn't really have much direction. But until I saw his stuff, sorry, that's right. If I saw one of his stuff, then once I saw his stuff. So I got mad distracted by some noise. Anyways, once I saw his stuff, I was motivated to get into black love art. And once I did my own black love art, that's when I knew what I wanted to do in terms of like subject matter. So he definitely played a huge role in that part. Now for the last guy, the guy who's looking up, first guy, that's Justin Wellington. So I'm pretty sure you're familiar with Justin Wellington.
I've heard the name, not familiar with his art though.
Oh, you haven't seen his work?
No.
You need to see his work. He's definitely another black artist that you definitely need to look into. His stuff is top notch. The reason why I say that is because, excuse me, I'm sorry. He's an artist that does realism, but hyper-realism. He actually, seeing his work actually motivated me to step my game up in terms of realism. Like the way he's able to execute realism just using only acrylic paint. Acrylic paint. If you look at his work, you think it's oil paint, but it's actually acrylic paint. And this goes out. And acrylic paint is not easy to use. It's not, because it dries extremely fast. So it's not easy to blend. I mean, unless you pour it into like a palette, but still, it's not easy to blend. To blend as like that at the same time, it's I find oil a little bit easier to work with because it's, you can easily blend with it. But yeah, the way he able to use acrylic is just amazing. And also the way he execute concepts and stories. All of his work contains these crazy concepts and stories. When you look at his work, he makes you actually study everything that's going on. It's not just extremely something simple. It's something that makes you really pay attention to what's going on, because there's always something new that you may see with his paintings. So. And also, he's a very cool guy. I've had the privilege of meeting him a couple of times. First time I met him was back in 2019, late February. So, and he had two drawings up in this art gallery called the Black Art Foundation. When I saw him, it was like on a Saturday, and I had nothing to do, so I was like, what the hell, he's here. I saw it on Facebook. They was gonna be at the Black Art Foundation, and I saw the post. I said, you know what, I gotta meet him. And when I met him, he actually wasn't. I was shocked at how humble he was, because I was thinking that he was probably going to be stuck up. Like, you know, like those typical artists are, they kind of stuck up, kind of have like an ego type of thing, but.
Right.
He was never like that at all.
Down to earth, brother.
Very down to earth. So, ever since then, that just took a tone with me. Like, that's the guy that I got to look up to.
That's what's up.
But now, like right now, he's like my favorite artist of this era. So like, you gotta check out his work. His work is phenomenal.
That's what's up, man. And by the way, once again, man, you're listening to a professional painter, professional artist. And everything that he, don't show it yet. No, don't show it yet. Oh, I thought you was giving it a show. Listening to a professional painter, man, professional artist, very humble brother, MJ Harrattan. And you can check out his stuff. He's on Etsy. I'm gonna have it right at the link below. You're gonna see it at the screen. You can check out his artwork. All of his artwork is on there, and he does all sorts of plans, payment plans. You want to pay him up front. You want to pay him half or whatever the case. You work that out with him. Just let him know, and he'll definitely work with you. So painters is not expensive. I'm not saying that. But there are some people who think that anything over $90 is expensive. This brother's painters is worth three times that amount, in my opinion. I got this one for you. That one right there.
Oh wow! Yes. Okay.
I'd love for you to tell.
So it's actually, I have it right here. So
absolutely, there you go.
There you go. What's crazy about this painting is that this actually was a study of a model that I did back in college. This is like back when I was still learning how to paint. nothing near as this to compared to this level. And I came across the canvas because I was in the mood to pay something. I didn't have money to get a new canvas at the moment. So I was thinking to myself, damn, I really want to paint. So I saw that canvas and I saw that painting and I'm thinking to myself, I don't want that painting anymore. I don't know who's going to want it. So I just gestured over it and started fresh. And then, you know, and I just had these feelings that I've been had trapped and mustered inside of me for so long on my feelings based on homelessness. Because you know, I live in New York City, and New York City, the cost of living is extremely high.
I know that to be a fact.
Yeah, extremely high. And because of that, it's a huge reason why homelessness over there is so high at an alarming rate, to a point where you can't escape it. Everywhere you go, it's there. If you walk in the street somewhere, you're gonna see one either ask you for change, or they're sleeping on the street somewhere, or especially if you're taking public transportation or riding the subway, forget about it.
Facts.
You're from NY, you're from the Bronx, so you know what
absolutely
I'm talking about.
So, I know.
So I didn't know at first. I didn't know how to express it, because at first I was thinking, "You guys should write something down to the mayor, asking how he's going to take care of the situation." But then I didn't know how to write it, because I'm not the best writer in the world. So I didn't know how would I express those feelings to the mayor. And first off, would he ever pay attention to it? So that I never went forward with that. So I figured, like, you know what? This time, maybe someday I should put it on canvas. But I kept procrastinating on it. So finally, like last year, I finally, like, okay, you know what? There's a way to finally do it. So I just did it. It hasn't gone viral yet, but hopefully my hope is for the painting to go viral and be like, you know, so people can really see it. Because I think this issue like really needs to be tackled in some way.
Why do you feel that? Why do you think that's the issue that needs to be tackled? And why should you be the one to try to tackle that?
Well, because it's a very serious issue. Because if you really think about it, and I hate to get all political, but we live in one of the most richest nations in the world. And it baffles me that homelessness is at an extreme high. If we live in such a rich country, then everybody should have access to a home. It doesn't matter if you're rich or don't have a whole lot of money, everyone still should have access to a home. There's homeless people who most likely have gone to college and earned a lot of degrees.
Yes.
And probably had a job at one point, but lost it all. Or just flat out just lost their home because they could no longer afford the rent, because the rent is sky high. There's people out there that are literally paying like more than $2,000 or up to $3,000 a month and can barely make ends meet. Probably have to work two jobs or three jobs they have to, and still probably it doesn't make the cut. So it's
right.
It's crazy.
Right. No, I agree. You know what I'm saying? The nation, a country that always preaches about you know, how great they are, how great the country is, and you have people that actually believe it. But this country has so much resources and so much riches, in which literally nobody should be homeless. Now, to be broke or to be in a situation where you're living from paycheck to paycheck, to be a little low on cash, I can understand that due to a circumstance. But to be homeless, to not have a home, that means that there are people who are getting people on a higher seat, getting down, getting over on the people who are on a lower seat. People are capitalizing off of other folks. And it just it should not be that way.
And what's really effed up, bro, the fact that they're so quick to give billions, up to $1 billion to supply war.
Yes.
Or supply other countries when there's thousands of people who don't have access to a home or food. Don't get me started on food. Don't get me started on food. They waste food every single day, bro. Where I work at, I work at Pace University, where I'm a security guard. Whatever food that's not sold to students or staff, they throw it away.
Mm, yeah.
They really throw it away. Mm-hmm. And the food, it's not like the food is spoiled. It's still fresh.
Yeah.
And I'm thinking to myself, they could have given that to the remaining food to maybe like some shelters that they could feed the homeless or whatever, or give it to maybe like some staffs that may want it. Something, like, don't throw it away.
Yeah, bro. Now, I agree with you 100%, bro. But lastly, I have this piece right here. This is personally my favorite. I think I've seen a lot of your paintings. I saw a lot of your pieces and sketches and pen art. And he's wicked with the pen too. Shout out to my girl DD too. She does pen art. He's wicked with the pen. But this one right here. I just think my phone doesn't do the justice. And in all honesty, yeah, it does not do. Man, just walk me through this one. This is my personal favorite, I think, of all time.
Okay.
Love this one, man. That one right there. When I saw that one, that painting to me, you solidify, in my opinion, and I stick by my opinion, it put you over Bob Ross. Listen, Bob Ross is a legend. I love Bob Ross. I haven't seen nothing like that from Bob Ross. And he's done some amazing paintings. That solidified it for me, and I stand by it. I'll battle anybody who wants to go against that. Please walk us through that one, brother.
Oh, excuse me. I appreciate that, first of all, man. I never heard anybody would even dare even say that. Yo, man, you above Bob Ross.
Yeah, that puts you over. That's right there. So we can move on to the next artist. That puts you over Bob Ross. I stand by that.
Okay. First off, for this painting, actually, I would say it's one of my favorite works of art, too, because... First off, it's because I think it really shows my growth as an artist in terms of skill. Because when I, in the middle of painting it, when I was looking, I'm thinking to myself, oh, wow, it looks so realistic.
Yes.
It's like, it looks like you're almost there.
Yes.
And the crazy thing is that for a very good long time, I've been trying to reach that level and achieve that level, and I would sometimes get so frustrated, like, damn, am I ever gonna get to that level of hyper realism where it looks like it looks so realistic that you look like you're actually there or something? So when I saw it, I was thinking, like, wow, I finally did it.
Yes.
So that's that. It was just fantastic and crazy to me. And okay, well, the breakdown of this piece is basically, I love Egypt, aka Kemet.
Yes.
I've been a huge fan of ancient Egyptian history ever since I was a little child. I'm still am to this day, even though I'm not like anal like it about it as I was when I was a child, but I'm still a fan. And I've done a lot of Egyptian themed art, but I think this is like top notch of them all. So I basically just wanted to do something simple, just do a portrait of showing the Sphinx and three pyramids. Now, the three pyramids, how they're positioned, and it's not 100%, it's not accurate like that. How I just wanted to put them all together, and yeah, I just wanted to put them all together so the viewers can see all three, but they're not actually positioned like that. So, but actually, if you look real close, there's I put in little hieroglyphics in there as well. In the clouds, I put in the Eye of Ra. I don't know if you can see it.
Yes.
And over here is a hieroglyphic of a bird. And down below in the Sphinx somewhere, I also put in maybe two hieroglyphics as well. So yeah.
That is, yo, man. So it's, what do you believe? Not even what you believe. I want to end it off with this. With your painting, what are you hoping to accomplish with your message? If anybody
say, painting or just my art alone?
Just with your paintings, as your all of your paintings. If someone says, "Well, we're gonna put these paintings into one sentence," what are you hoping to get across from as MJ as an artist when people see your paintings that may not ever meet you, but when they see it, what are you hoping that they feel? What message do you want them to receive?
Being black is not painful, it's not negative, it's not savage, it's not disgusting. It's instead beautiful, amazing, triumphant, ravishing, all that good stuff. That's the message that I want to put out with my art. And also with the Black History thing, a lot of us have been conditioned to think that our history started off as us coming from slaves.
Right.
And because all you see is just, when it comes to history, is us as slaves.
That's right.
But yet they never show the history of when our ancestors being kings, queens, or scholars, scientists, the whole enchilada. And I like to study about that. I want to know about that. I want to know about like the positive stuff about us.
Yes.
Not this, that the negative stuff they try to push, that the media tries to push at us. So that's what my art is about. I like to push the positive images of us. You notice that I've never done any negative image of anything that's related to black people. The only thing, except if it's something that's political and it's having to do with maybe like police brutality or racism, that's right. Not it. But other than that, no. Because there's enough of that already.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Yo, we got 1 minute left, man. MJ, yo, just let everyone know who is listening, where they can find us, where they can find your art, websites and everything. Just drop it down the line, brother.
Okay, so whoever's watching, what's up, y'all? My name is MJ Harrattan, aka Malik John Artist. You can find me mainly on Instagram, same name. On Facebook, it's MJ Harrattan. Right now, I do have an online shop on Etsy.com, which is MasterJ@Etsy.com. But I am planning on shutting it down eventually. So if you do want to, if you would like to own any of my artwork, you can basically either maybe you can hit me on Instagram, but I prefer that you hit me up personally on my email, which is MalikJohnArtist@Outlook.com. That's the best way to contact me in case you would love to own any of my art.
Got it. My brother, man, it's been a pleasure.
Yes.
It's been a pleasure, man. And I appreciate you for all you do, brother. You know
Thank
what I'm saying?
You.
Appreciate you for all you do. Yo, that is No Compromise Media. MJ, Malik John Artist, y'all.
Peace out, y'all. And thank you, brother.
Much love, bro. Much love.